Okay. My name is Jing Jing. I'm the writer and director of Cowboy Joe Redux. It's a short film about a Chinese girl who wants to be a cowboy. It's dear and close to my heart. So thank you so much for coming. And we'll have a short Q&A after the table read. So please send me your questions via the chat or the Q&A, and I will pose the questions to the cast after the table read. So without further ado, the whole cast is going to introduce themselves and then we'll get started. So I'll pass it off to Condor, our narrator.
Hey everyone, I'm Condor. I'm the narrator. I'm an actor previously based in New York City, now in San Francisco. And I worked on Jing Jing previously on her short film, Cowboy Joe. That's me. Thank you.
My name is Skylar. I'm 7 years old. I live in Brooklyn. And I'm younger.
Hi, my name's Matilda Sakamoto. Oh, sorry, my roommate's walking. I'm a choreographer, dancer, and actor from Los Angeles and based in Brooklyn.
Hi, my name's Lei Zhou. I'm playing father of Joey, and I'm from China.
Oh, I think, Mom, I think you're on mute. We can't hear you.
Sorry. My name is Rosina Leong. I'm an actress based on New York City, and I'm playing Joey's mom.
My name is Hannah Hale. I am playing College Girl. I am an actress and a writer based in New York City. I live in a neighborhood, little tiny neighborhood called Two Bridges.
Hi, my name's Colin Van. DJ.
Hey folks, my name is Melissa Johnson. I'm a writer and filmmaker living in Los Angeles. And I'm very happy today to be reading for the part of Horse Handler.
Okay, we're all gonna turn off our videos and start the table read. Thank you so much.
Cowboy Joe Redux, written and directed by Jing Jing Tian. Inside the living room in Ridgewood, Queens, in the late afternoon, Joey sits watching television. She flips through the channels and lands on a Western. Her mouth gaps open. She's fascinated. As her parents begin to argue, she directs her gaze towards the kitchen and back to the television. As their argument escalates, she scoots closer to the television and turns up the volume. Her eyes glaze over. You can see the cowboys on her cornea.
I mean, kill in 1 minute, Ned. Or see you hanging in Fort Smith at Judge Parker's convenience. Which will be.
Joey's father enters the room and turns off the TV. He returns to the kitchen where the argument continues. Joey, slowly and hesitantly, turns the TV back on. Her father suddenly returns and rips the television cord out of the wall. He eyes Joey meaningfully and returns to the kitchen where the fight continues. Joey, scared, stares after her father. She crawls towards the back of the television and plugs in the cord. As the TV turns back on, her father snaps into the room. He drags Joey by the arm across the floor. Joey begins to scream. Her father continues dragging her by the arm up the stairs. Joey can feel the carpet burn her skin as she continues to scream. Her cries for help go unanswered as bone hits floor. Her father drags Joey up the stairs, shoves her into her bedroom, and slams the door shut. Inside Joey's bedroom. Joey, breathing heavily on the floor, stares after the closed door. She takes her hands and cups them into the shape of a gun. She aims at the door.
Pew, pew, pew!
Inside the karaoke bar, daytime. The walls are painted black. Joey, older, nerdy with glasses and acne-faced, counts money at the register. She looks like someone who spends all of her time playing video games in a dark room, but she's dressed like a cowboy. Plaid shirt, Wranglers, belt buckle, bolo tie, and hat. Her hair is braided into pigtails. A group of college-age girls are leaving.
No, that's exactly what I said. Yeah, nose. Hey.
Hi.
You know, you might be pretty if you don't wear that.
The college girl takes her credit card and pushes the signed receipt towards Joey.
Just a thought.
They leave. Inside the kitchen, same day. Joey walks into the house and pauses. She hears crying from the living room. Loud, dark night of the soul sobs. She closes the door gently and softly. Now inside the living room. She tiptoes to the edge of the living room. There, crumbled on the floor, is her father bawling his eyes out. His back is facing her. Shocked, she almost shrinks back. He continues to cry. She approaches him quietly.
Dad.
He places a hand on his shoulder and he jerks away. He doesn't recognize her for a moment.
What are you doing home?
He wipes his tears away and gathers himself up. He leaves. She stares after him. Inside Joey's bedroom, later. In the dark, Joey sits on her bed, watching a Western while eating a Pop-Tart. Inside the karaoke bar, the next day. Joey is back at the bar, wearing a different cowboy getup. She's cleaning the counter when a group of rowdy college guys leave their room. They're drunk.
Well, 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 what do we have here? Yeehaw! Oh, it's a girl! Hey, guys, it's a girl!
Joey passes him a receipt.
Here's your receipt.
Hey, are you a girl or are you a boy? I said, are you a girl or are you a boy?
Here's your receipt.
She pushes the receipt towards him to get him to close out.
You want my phone number? Why not?
I don't know.
Because you gotta stick up your butt?
No, please leave.
Hey, look at me! I'm so cool, I dress like a cowboy and I can do whatever I want.
He gets in her face.
I'm so cool, I'm a Chinese cowboy. Ching chong, ching chong, ching.
Joey keeps her head down and pushes the receipt towards him.
You want to kiss me?
Just leave.
The rowdy guy tips Joey's hat and knocks it off of her head. Joey backs away in fear. She doesn't know what to do. Her body clamps up. Everyone else is laughing. The rowdy guy signs the receipt. She pretends to intimidate her. She flinches. He laughs, and they leave. Joey collapses. Her lips quiver. Her face is distraught and dotted with sweat. She's about to cry. Inside the kitchen, in the evening. Joey runs into the kitchen, holding in her tears. She finds her father reading a newspaper at the kitchen table. He looks up as she runs in. She joins him at the table. She tries to make herself small. He puts down the paper.
What happened?
Joey is silent. She doesn't know how to answer. She looks down at the table and begins to cry silently. She tries to hold it in, but can't. Her father is uncomfortable. He's a combination of annoyed, confused, and angry.
Are you crying?
He reaches over and pats her awkwardly on the back.
It's good, it's good.
A jumble of words and cries escape. She cries even harder now. He makes his way over to his daughter. She cries into his chest as he awkwardly holds her.
What is that? Listen to your father. Don't dress like that anymore. Everything will be normal.
But I like dressing this way.
What's wrong with you?
Nothing.
They're just movies. Imaginary. No one really lives like that. Not crying anymore, okay? Stinking girl, right? Wash your face, okay?
Slowly, she makes her way up the stairs. Inside the living room, next day in the morning. Joey, dressed like a normal girl in jeans and a t-shirt, bounces down the stairs. She's about to walk into the kitchen when she overhears her parents. She pauses and listens out of view.
She came home yesterday, cry a ball of tears. Guess what was she was crying about? A bunch of boys made fun of her for dressing like a cowboy.
Someone like her, I don't know if she can change. She's so stubborn.
You'll learn. She'll learn.
This conversation is in Chinese. Joey looks down at her regular clothes, her shirt, jeans, white athletic socks that come in a pack of six. She swallows and walks into the kitchen. Her father sees her.
Hey! Good! Pretty! Beautiful!
She keeps her head down, doesn't make eye contact with her parents, puts on sneakers and leaves the house.
She doesn't even say hello.
Joey pauses. She wants to say something, but knows better and walks away. Inside the karaoke room, daytime. Joey slams into an empty karaoke room, shuts the door and locks it behind her. She sits on the couch and scrolls through a list of songs. She finds the one that she's looking for.
Are you lonesome tonight? Do you miss me tonight? Are you sorry we drifted apart? Does your memory stray to a brighter sunny day?
Inside B24, afternoon. The rumble of a bus. Joey settles into a seat. She crouches into her seat and looks out of the window as the sun splashes her face. Outside on Sunrise Stables. Joey walks towards the stable. She watches from a distance as a horse handler with sun-bleached hair and coarse skin unloads hay. Joey works up the courage to approach the woman. her hands in her pockets. She nods politely and shyly.
Hi.
Heya.
I was wondering if I could learn to ride horses or something.
They give lessons up at,
Sorry. Can I trade work for lessons?
It's hard work.
I'll work hard.
What's your name?
Oh, sorry, Joey.
You'll have to get real boots.
Really?
3 days a week.
Joey nods. They talk over the details. Close up of a horse. Joey extends her hand to feed it. As the horse draws near him, she retrieves, afraid.
It's okay. Nice and gentle.
Joey approaches again, slowly. The horse licks her hand. She lets out an excited giggle. She's petrified and happy. The sun shines brightly. She pets the horse. She looks calm and serene, maybe for the first time in her life. Inside Joey's bedroom, later. Joey's rendition of Are You Lonesome Tonight continues softly in the background. She's in front of the mirror, down to her white underwear and white bra. On her bed is a plaid shirt, Wranglers, and a cowboy hat. She dresses. Inside the karaoke room, earlier, Joey is standing up now. She copies Elvis's voice.
You know, someone said that the world's a stage and each must play a part. Fate had me playing in love with you as my sweetheart. Act one was when we met. I loved you at first glance. You read your lines so cleverly, never missed a cue. Then came act two. You seemed to change and you acted strange, and why, I'll never know. Honey, you lied to me when you said you loved me, and I had no cause to doubt you. But I'd rather go on hearing your lies than go on living without you. So now the stage is bare, and I'm standing there with emptiness all around. And if you won't come back to me, then make them bring the curtain down.
Inside Joey's bedroom, nighttime. She puts on the final touch. She places the cowboy hat snugly onto her head. She looks into the mirror and smiles. Inside the stairs. Joey's boots are at the edge of the stairs. The camera follows as the boots make their way down the stairs and into the kitchen. Inside the kitchen, Joey's parents are sitting at the table when they look up. There, before them, from her boots and spurs all the way up to her head, is Joey, back in her cowgirl costume. Her parents are shocked and confused.
What's this?
There's a new sheriff in town, and her name is Joey. I heard you talking about me. What do you have to say for yourself?
Don't be silly. Try to be an adult.
Why can't you be nice to me? I mean to kill you in 1 minute, Ned, or see you hang in Fort Smith at Judge Barker's convenience. Which will it be?
Lay, is she mentally ill?
Control yourself.
Why did you call me stupid?
Because you're being crazy.
Why can't you just be nice to me?
Not everything is about you.
Nothing is about me.
She takes one hard look at her parents and walks out into the darkness of the night. outside the house in the night. In the dark, we see a silhouette of Joey amongst the chitter-chatter of cicadas. Outside the street, in the evening time, Joey rides on her childhood bike. She is flying out of the handles. A cowgirl on her horse.
Thank you so much. If I can ask all the actors to turn on their videos. Thank you so much for this virtual table read and for all of our attendees for watching this and participating in this table read with us. If you have any questions or anything, please let me know or type them into the chat and we can have a little conversation. I don't know if our actors can read the compliments, so I'll read them out loud. From Filmy Arts Global, love Joey's acting, wonderful actor. Karen Coleman, clapping. Jacob Lamb, this was amazing, great job. Filmy Arts Global, cheers. So, if you have any questions, just raise your hand and I will ask it. I guess I'll start to all the actors. What was it like sort of rehearsing via Zoom and then having to sort of perform via Zoom sort of almost theatrically versus like when you do it in real life? I mean, not that this isn't real life, but like versus like doing it in person.
I can go first. it's interesting, you know, it's honestly not that different working virtually on Zoom versus like being in a very like tightly managed play almost. It's just like different circumstances in terms of technology versus being in person, of course. But yeah, it's funny how organized you have to be for everything to work out, but there's also like room for improvisation, which I think is really cool. And you did an amazing job, Jing Jing.
Thank you. Does anybody else want to take a crack at that question?
I think one of the major differences for me in terms of theater and film is that shared energy that you have with a group of people and or the audience. And it's much different in this arena where we're all in our own little box, our own little square, and trying to navigate how to share the story with one another. So it's a great medium that's allowed us to do this, but let's get back to the real thing. Let's get back to the real thing.
And I'll ask another question. What was the most challenging or most fun part of the story itself, like in approaching the story and acting it out. And what were like some of the fun moments that you had in acting in this?
I can go, I guess. I'm like fairly new to acting. I did like a play before. And this is kind of like my second thing, I guess, just like from straight acting. But it was fun because there's like a lot of things in with the character that I feel like I relate to in a lot of ways, but then her actions and things are quite different than mine. So it was fun to try to like find a character, but still have it feel authentic. Yeah.
I'm just waiting on a question from Jacob. I guess while we wait on that question from Jacob, I'll just ask a question to Skylar, who played young Joey. How is it for you? I know it's some sort of, it's kind of the most violent scene in the whole entire short film. And also, you're a kid, so how was it acting on Zoom? And what are your takeaways?
It was fine. I actually gave fun, but I also think it thought it was a little easy because I was only in one scene.
I think that means she wants you to write a bigger part for her next time, Jing Jing.
Yeah, good point, Melissa. How was it for you, Melissa, having that sort of also few short scenes? Did all the actors want longer scenes or?
Oh, it was fun. Yeah, no, it was really fun. It was really fun to watch my fellow actors and it just felt like a wonderful escape to get to do this.
I'm glad that you use that word escape because when I wrote it for the lead character, sort of watching these cowboy films and spaghetti westerns and, you know, going to the horse stable, sort of an escape for her from her sort of daily life. And it sort of gives her like this comfort. Jacob, I don't know if you've written down your question, but I don't see it. So we'll just wait a few more minutes and then we'll end the Q&A. Thank you so much, everyone, for being part of this. It was really fun to sort of direct it and be a part of it in each of our individual rooms. And I think Hannah really nailed it on the head when she answered the first question, which is there's a lot of logistics and a lot of like, you have to be super organized. You're like, okay, now I have to click this and then click that. So in addition to like being an actor or something, every person on the Zoom has had to be like their own tech person in addition to like acting. So it's like, you have to really like write down all these notes and make sure you hit them. So bravo to all the actors today. Okay, here's the question from Jacob. Uh, Regarding story-wise, do you plan on adding more details for why Joey's dad isn't a huge fan of his daughter being the cowboy? I think, and speaking from growing up in a Chinese family, no worries, Jacob, take your time. I think in the interest of a short film or even a feature film or even a play, I think, or in a story, you know, even when you write anything, there's just, you know, for us, for all of us, every person on this panel and the audience, we go through life and there's so much in life, right? Like every single day, there's something new and you can't really kind of put everything in a story. And also sometimes, I like to pose this to my fellow actors. It's like, sometimes there are people who do things and I really don't understand them why. So I think I wrote it from the place like my parents didn't understand me and I couldn't understand them. And we tried to communicate to each other, but we just couldn't. So it's like, for me, I just wanted to be an artist and, you know, and they just couldn't understand why. And I just couldn't understand why they can't support that. And so, yeah, so I wrote it sort of like, for Joey, she just has this interest, you know, she kind of fell in love with these cowboys, almost like, you know, Star Wars, like the first time she saw them is just so different and new, and she sort of fell in love. And then that also moment of domestic violence as he kind of, you know, drags her up the stairs is sort of also impregnated a different sort of understanding about the cowboys. In her, sort of almost like, you know, the cowboy's way of life, right, is about right and wrong and using gun and violence to sort of communicate that. And so for her, the cowboy culture isn't just the cowboy culture anymore. It becomes like sort of this internalized subconscious view of right and wrong, how to stand up for yourself. Oh, here's a question from Karen. How do you see the relationship to your first film, Cowboy Joe, to this Redux in terms of exploring identity? Oh my gosh, these are really good questions and really tough questions. I wish my actors could answer them. I don't really know. I sort of made the first one about a male character because it was just easier for me to sort of project my feelings and thoughts onto a character that wasn't a female. And with this one, I wanted to make a longer short film and to sort of give a little bit of background on the character. So we get to see her as a young child, then we get to see her as a young adult. So in the first short film, Cowboy Joe, it's just pretty much one or two scenes and you just see him as this young adult who tells his father he wants to be a cowboy. So I just wanted to sort of expand on that. And also just kind of also talk about how trauma, even if we forget it, can sort of have a subconscious impact on us, even though we might not know it later on in life. So, but that's a really good question. It's a tough question to answer. So, but yeah, it's, and much like the first one, it's sort of saying, you know, the character saying that she wants to be a cowboy, saying that she wants to be an American. She wants to be recognized as an American and to be part of this culture. Okay, thank you so much. Thanks everyone to all the actors, all the attendees, all the questions. I'm so grateful. Thank you so much for bringing this alive. And yeah, like what Melissa said, she played the horse handler. It was really fun. It was just like, there's just moments of laughter and kind of joy during this quarantine. So thank you. If all of you want to turn on your mics and sort of say your goodbye or just a little short comment, that would be great.
Yeah, well, thank you so much, guys. It was, I've never been a narrator for any table read, much less a virtual one. So I just had a lot of fun doing this with everybody and really happy to be here. Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, thanks so much for joining. I've never been a horse handler online in real life. Ever. So thanks for the opportunity. Have a great rest of your day.
Thanks, everybody.
Thank you, everyone. It was fun working with y'all. And I learned a lot, the tech stuff from this Zoom table read. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thanks, Jing Jing, for asking me to be a part of this.
Yeah, thank you, Jingjing, for putting all this together. Very cool.
Thanks, Jingjing, and congrats to everyone. Great work. Enjoy a lot. Happy to work with you. So happy.
Lovely meeting you all.
Cool.
Okay. Right. Thank you. Thank you so much. So grateful. Okay. Have a wonderful week and wonderful month.
See you guys.
Bye.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you to our audience.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.